Greetings again from Seoul, Korea, and welcome to the GSL. I'm Tasis with me is Artosis, and you will see in just a moment here that we are actually changed seats. I don't know if we're going to shout out or not, but
yeah.
Since we have to be observing here.
Tasis, you, sir, are actually an excellent observer.
Thank you.
You tell a story with your observing. It's a beautiful sight to behold.
I think it's actually that I've done more observing than you.
You tell a story with your observing.
So, just so you know, guys, I'll be doing the observing from here on.
I, on the other hand, just click around quickly and look at eBay's, see upgrades and stuff. So, all right. Talderim Altar. Tasteless, I think that line is going to take this tournament home.
Yeah,
not just this match, but this tournament.
Dude, you may be actually 100% correct. I mean, line is really looking impressive, looking scary.
Yeah.
And can I also point out, while I'm sitting here in this chair with your headset on,
yeah,
your headset's better than mine.
Is it?
Feel it. Did you feel that the ear on your left?
Yeah,
ear?
No.
It's
looser. Well, I figured it's because I have this on backwards. So that
no, oh, you know what? Maybe that is right.
Yeah. That's it, man.
The countdown started. Line against OGS Top. Can Line do it? This dark horse of the tournament world. OGS Top, a man with more results, proved to be the victor in this series. Let's find out here. Head-to-head at the GSL. I think it would sound better in these headphones, man. I like that little nerd laugh you did. Over here, in the upper left, we have the one Dark Horse player here.
Tenetsu Live.
And I actually might have to turn up this mouse sensitivity. I'll see what I can do. I can't do it. There he is. Line. And the crowd goes wild. Over here, in the upper right, we have... And I'm sorry, Artosis. Hold
no,
on
go ahead.
Second.
They haven't actually switched your computer yet.
It's mouse sensitivity. This does not feel right. All right, that's
there
for
we go.
My liking. Thank you.
All right, wait, all right. No, we aren't on you yet.
We'll be back coming soon, so I had to turn up the sensitivity. It was way too low. So thank you, LG, G-Skill, and Intel. Okay.
We may just have
the
observer.
We may just go back to the other observer. For the time being.
All right. I was getting excited having some storm observerness.
No. Well, it's okay. If we get everything sorted out, we'll find out what happens. It's fine. But I guess we're back on the normal observer. Sorry, guys. This is live TV, as we've said before. So when problems come up, we can't just be like, cut.
Nope. Can't do that. All right. So, pool going up. Should be followed by gas. I feel like Line is definitely going to do what he's been doing every game. He's done it basically every single time, which is awesome because the more I'm like actually searching it for holes and figuring out in my head what I would do as a Terran player to destruct this build. And I'm having a hard time of it. And that's normally what you can do with someone that's too stylish.
Well,
you can look
maybe
and be like,
go
oh.
Marine Hellion with it to stop.
Well, that's actually
like
what
this.
I was just... That was what
why
I was just thinking
so,
in my head, actually.
Why are we so smart?
No, you're quite
why
right.
Why are we so good?
Thing is, if someone's going to invest all their money into mutas, you can go basically probably Marine Hellion Medivac because obviously
but,
that's going to weak to Banes.
If you get a good flank, though, get a good surround. Yeah,
so, I love this match in particular, Tasteless.
You mean this matchup? This match,
this one that we're watching right now, because. This underlines something that I've said many
because
times. A lot of times people say, you know, what do you feel about the current balance of the game? And I'm like, you know, I feel like it's pretty well balanced. And what's happening is people are getting different levels of understandings with strategies, and it goes through cycles. And this may be starting possibly a small cycle of Zerg owning up Terran, because Terrans are going to have to look at this. If this style does stay as strong as it's beginning to look, Tasteless, and it's a perfect situation where you're like, look at this guy figured this out, and now we're going to have Zerg be awesome for a bit.
Yeah.
And maybe that's going to spark Terrans to be like, oh, you can't beat it. But
meanwhile,
eventually something will be figured out.
The guys in the forums are like, but in Silver League, you can't stop this. No, man. Shut up.
All right, so we have the Queen Bean chasing that SCV. Zerglings all around, speed on the way, queens being made, going up to three queens immediately. You know, I want to have a conference hall with a translator. Grab John or Juani to have him translate for me to all the Korean pro Zergs and just explain to them that they need to get a creep tumor in their main base to connect their main and their natural.
I'm a bit startled that you don't ever see the creep tumor.
No one.
You know what I mean?
No Koreans do it, really. It's so few. Very, very few.
Oh, my God. That was so close.
That actually could have been game.
That could have been, like, the end of the game. I'm like, all right, guys, I'll see you later.
Kill seven SCVs, and then 20 minutes later, the game's over. It's like, well.
Well, that would be sad.
Yeah, good thing he did that. I like that little door, man. That's a cute little door he has going on.
Yeah, he's got a little door.
He can put add-ons on, too.
Oh, yeah, he can. Look at that. No, but he's going to make a depot there.
Or that. That's fine.
He's going to mess with the feng shui of this, this Terran house. How many drones is he getting before he checks the layer? Let's find out. He's so far, he's got 29. This is going to be good because this build's kind of new.
Mm-hmm. Pace is mapping it out.
I'm mapping it out.
Getting out his build order.
Well, I got the computer where I can actually look around and stuff.
Yeah. How are you liking that?
I have a lot more that I can talk about.
Mm-hmm.
So no layer yet.
Banning nest on the way. This is interesting. It's different. He's changed it. He's getting some additional gases. Top right now, going for a reactor. It looks like that's going to be for the starport, of course.
He might actually react to that and make two medevacs into a drop.
Now, Line kind of is getting a ton of gas all at once in this Bailey nest. I wonder, and he's making like pure drone as well.
Yeah, he's not going to do the same build. I think he might actually.
I thought he was going to do maybe some Bailey aggression. Which
yeah, but
I guess
four
he could.
Gases, is that actually...
If he does four gases, that means he might be making enough banelings to kill the barracks off.
That's what I was thinking, yeah.
18-lings on the way, man. Might be.
All right.
Instead of going for those depots, if he goes for the barracks...
Terran's doing a variation of a fast expand build where you do a very, very, very quick drop.
Tasteless.
Yes.
Stim is only halfway done. If he times this just right and hits
he
right
before
the stim,
barracks?
If you go against only Marines with Bane speed... And he has no stim quite yet. Could be huge. So let's see what he's going to do. That is a ton of Banelings.
You know what's
20
funny?
20 Banes.
Is the Terran's trying to throw off the Zerg with this rush, or basically you get a drop that's so quick of them. They're not prepared. They're in trouble. And see, here we go.
My
this
God.
Is what I'm talking about. He's
going
to Baneling plus as Top is leaving.
Is uh-oh, Top going to actually see this? Yeah, he is.
Oh, dude.
He's going to have to turn around.
Ah!
And will he go for the barracks? He is going for the barracks.
No stim.
Oh my God, the SCVs could go down, but don't. And stim is not, well, it does finish, but he only has one barracks. It's going to be hard to remake all those Marines right away. All right, so that was really interesting. And he remakes those two barracks. I feel like when all those SCVs came out, if he had just hit those with the Banelings, the game would be, the game would still be going on, but it'd be over. You know? Just like Shell Art. So
it's over. Thanks for ruining Shell Art.
We do have the drops coming out now. A layer is on the way, making a ton of Banelings.
I'm actually surprised that he's even going to drop. I guess
I am
actually,
loving
this. You know, it's fine. It's fine. I take it back.
Two queen, targeting medevac. Get out of here, medevac.
Right, I'm leaving. Jeez.
Dude, you're such a douche.
And here come the Banes again, Tasteless.
And he's just all I gotta say is Terran's gonna be very
careful. The Banelings are going around the center. He's medevacs. Oh God, this is going to be brutal. The barracks are gonna go down again, Tasteless.
Oh, absolutely. The medevacs looking for an opening.
Here we go.
The expansion.
Going for the barracks once again.
Look
oh my
at this.
God,
this is art.
This is sickness of skill, Tasteless.
Look at this.
He's
getting in there.
He's like...
I'm actually astounded at these... Okay, nice!
Give me some numbers, Tasteless.
But there's a drop over here in the expansion.
Oh, that's a pretty big drop. It's at the main base. Killing off some overlords. He's sending his drones. No! That's the worst thing you can do.
Uh-oh.
32 drones against 18 SCVs at the moment.
There's just not enough... there's too many medevacs here for this to actually be effective. Well, now the links are out, it's different, but you know what I'm saying.
That is a very hurt medevac. Almost right. Killed it. Oh, my
29,
God.
29 drones to 19 SCVs.
And he was way further ahead than he actually attacked with those drones. I'm actually surprised he did that.
That was a blunder.
It is one in a billion times correct to attack Marines with drones in that situation. Anyways, it looks like they are both going to stabilize. 53 supply to... 57 with Top just in the lead.
Zerg, you know, stop making bailings for a little bit after that big attack and actually has enough gas to make a considerable number of mutas. So he's going to get a Spire. He may do one more baneling. Actually, no, he probably won't. Let's see, only four banelings.
Yeah,
what he's
going to
do
banes.
Is just make a ton of mutas now. No, no, the, Zerg, the Terran did lose the barracks there for a little bit. He's remaking tech labs and all that jazz. I don't even think Marines have combat shields. No, they don't.
We do have this nice little drop coming over. Looks like he's going to do a little gully push, perhaps. There it is.
Gully is a cute word, isn't it?
Yeah. That's what I used to call Guile in Street Fighter when I was a kid.
You call him Gully?
I thought his name was Gully, man.
In my life.
I never heard the name Guile.
All right, this is a good move here. But no, mutas are going to be out here pretty soon.
Oh!
So sick.
Snipes the Hurt Medivac, kills off the Marines inside it as well. This would have been a much more powerful maneuver that had not occurred. As is, it's actually not that strong. In fact, making six mutas, he'll be able to take all that out with that if he micros correctly. This Medivac making its hasty escape.
Now he is going to drop over here, but there's not a lot of time to make this work.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's going to get any key structures or if he's even going to get a good enough number of workers. Because when the mutas pop out,
it's over.
Siege tank's gone, Marines are gone.
Might take out the spawning pool, which is actually
that's great.
Very, very good.
Spawning pool, yeah.
Hey, man, killing spawning pools pretty much one MLG for MMA, so.
Yeah, no kidding.
And here we go. Going after these Marines, and easy peasy lemon squeezy. Down goes that medevac.
Look
in a
at
second.
That. Nice.
Down it goes. Kill the Marines, kill the siege tank. But a big drop is on the way. Zerglings there to stop it.
And as you can see, the siege tank cannot see up on high ground, so you can actually leave that, take care of that later. The entrance to the Terran's base should be safe from the Zerg trying
to
bust it.
Yeah, with those siege tanks there, I'm not sure if this is something he actually wants to commit in. And he doesn't. Turns around.
And note, Zerg has been so aggressive for so long, Zerg does not have a third base.
That's quite true. This has been a very bizarre game, much different than the other games. Very similar supplies, 82 to 86. Mutas just flying around, flippy-flapping their wings. Sea Chanks going to stop a Mutalist grasping. Realize they can't hit air, run away. Go back.
Oh, nice. A little bit of a hole.
Oh, only one missile. Two missile turrets. Taking some damage. Not really doing as much as he wants.
Zerg didn't lose more during that.
Lost a lot of health. Oh, down one goes.
Zerg right now kind of in a sticky situation, even base, even supply. But
he doesn't have a lot of drones, man.
He does not have a lot of drones.
He only has 35 drones against 40 SCVs, and this is actually what we saw in that Metalopolis game. I feel like once Line loses drones, he just doesn't really remake them very
easily. Top doesn't need to attack right now. Zerg's on two base, not on three. And if Zerg can get enough mutas together, and
that's
going to
be hard. That's actually a lot of Marines.
Yeah.
He does not have Baneling speed. He does not have Baneling speed on the way. This is going to be hard, Tasteless.
Here we go.
There are a lot of mutas, but are there enough? There we go. Turns around, kills the siege tank.
Does get the siege tank. One small victory.
Yeah, only one tank left. Making more lings, making more mutas. This guy does not like Banes. I don't like Banes anymore either. I'm done with Banes. Well, actually, against Protoss, they're awesome, but that's funny how that switched around, huh?
Yeah, I know.
Suddenly, it seems like Banelings are good against Protoss, but not Terran.
overstim there, but actually, I guess it's okay considering the number of medevacs.
Yeah, that's a good number of medevacs.
Air attack is almost complete.
Ah, losing some mutas. You know, the one thing about this style chase is you really can't be losing any mutas.
No, I mean, the mutas are supposed to get...
Oh, what's this? Oh, and he goes out of the medevac. Huge mistake by Top.
He's going to do it again.
Oh, and he makes the same mistake twice, but doesn't lose it the second time. So I guess it's not as much of a mistake.
Oh, my God. He's getting these medevacs so quickly. That was a large chunk of the Terran's army there.
Yeah. Those medevacs, very, very important. He's stimming a lot.
The next group of reinforcements is coming out. And it looks like suddenly Top is just, like, falling apart, man.
Oh, dude. This Mutalisk harassment is just out of this world phenomenal. Look at that.
Nice.
Makes the Marines go back, and he is going to probably clean this all up. The Terran does have to run away. Does not want to get hit by those Banes. Oh, that's
nice
some fancy
stutter step micro. Fancy pants.
And the Mutas do have to run. Ooh, taking a few more Muta kills than he really wanted.
But Zerg still doesn't have an additional base. And Terran's actually finished the orbital now.
Top is winning. He's 95 spy to 81. Even though he's losing these armies, there is not much of a game plan here.
Oh, man.
Oh. That's actually too much damage. That was terrible, terrible damage.
That was Dustin Browder damage. All right, this should be GG, I think.
It may be.
I mean, even if he keeps holding this up, Zerg's not getting another base.
Oh, finally, you just started that hatchery.
Yep, just started one.
Trying to deal with the straw.
You know, Lion is very good at with the transfusions on the Mutas. We don't see that a lot.
You know, Fruit Dealer, one of the first players to really do that in a tournament. Not the first, but one of. It's a beautiful thing to see. Mutas are actually so expensive. It's a good way to use green energy.
Yeah, it's like, you normally think about they're going to use it on Ultralisks, but in fact, you know, using it on Mutalisks is totally fine.
Yeah. Well, Mutas flying around trying to find somewhere to harass. Baneling speed finally started, but his production is pretty low right now. You know, we have 37 drones against 58 SCVs. The third base has landed for Terran, so top is just crushingly getting far ahead. I love the opening. I love the switching it into like a billion banelings to kill barracks, but
You just don't develop into the later
games. Yeah. Finally, he is droning up a little bit, getting his plus two muta attack as well. So he wants to remain with this style. Can't blame him for it, but
he's had success before with it.
Yeah, I feel like he needs to get Burrow right now, and he's gonna go after this turret. And barely doesn't take it down. That is heartbreaking.
You know, we've seen Lion's Mutas continuously crash into the other opponent's defenses or army. And he's having Mutalisk casualties because of that.
He is indeed. And here comes some speedlings.
Let's see. Terran is moving out with a medevac.
Well, Lion, you need to make a lot of Mutas, my friend. And a lot of, well, not Mutas, but drones right now, really. He needs a lot of drones. And he's started a macro hatch, interestingly enough. He's down by 30 supply. Medevac moving out, as well as an army of top. Baneling speed is done, so. Only two banelings. Normally you see people with like 40 banes.
I know,
right,
that's
now.
It's kind of what makes this whole matchup kind of interesting. You know, it's weird because you see Zerg kind of staying in the mid-tier for so long here.
I think that's how he likes to win, you know?
Exactly, exactly.
His very end game seems to be like two infestors, you know?
Yeah.
It's just because by then you're just so heavy on the
Oh!
Oops. That is just an unforgivable mistake, losing two mutas like that.
This SCV is somehow going to get inside the Zerg's main base. It's like the scariest moment in this SCV's life. Drop over here in the bottom left.
Yeah, at the third base, which isn't mining.
We have a drop. We get a shot of that.
The mutas do clean it up, though. And as they clean up, drones do arrive to finally mine it. It's been up for a while. And his mutas are not up there, so top does the elevator. Quite an elevator indeed. Does he have enough? Beautiful pickup. Killing off those front Marines. No more Marines there. All of them in the back. We'll be able to take out some Sea Shanks in back.
Not enough.
No, it's not. GG. And it looks like we're going to go on to a fifth and final deciding game.
Yay. Well, that was certainly one of the cooler. What is that?
Is he eating chocolate?
He's gonna get his sugar high.
He's gonna go to some chocolate. You know, that's. Get a little glucose in your brain. Smile again.
Not about it. Lion can't be happy with that. I think he may be regretting deviating from his normal style. Top is close to doing this. This is one of his toughest opponents yet. Frankly, he's having a tougher time against Lion than he was against his team.
Oh, yeah. Well, Top just kind of did lots of early aggression against Nesty. And he tried that at least the game before this against Lion. But Lion had his number, man.
Yeah.
Lion was like,
He really did.
He's like, I don't die to beta builds. I'm sorry.
Sorry, bro. Brozef. Broham. We're here at the GSL Super Tournament. Super awesome, amazing tournament. Largest prize pool here.
In esports, perhaps ever.
Ever.
In fact, I'm pretty sure it's the biggest ever in esports. Because yep. I remember when we announced GSL 1, it was the biggest. And now this is the biggest.
We haven't been topped yet either. The next map will be Zelda, actually the last map as well,
yeah.
Will be Zeldnaga Caverns.
What a decider.
That's like George Bush decider. I'm a decider. He is actually, well, I don't have anything else to say. Countdown started. It's time. Who's going to win? One of these guys is going to go into the final four. Let's find out who that's going to be here at the GSL with Taste and Artosis.